this make me feel different. I swear I don't feel. Make me feel different. I swear I don't feel. Never feel.
Just get established. Better bow her head when I walk past. Away your manners. As a kid, stay with my granny. Daddy went to jail for jail. Lost my only chance being happy. Damn, what happened? Outcome match my actions. Talk, then I back it. Great example. I'm the standard. Come to preaching what you practice. Actually, I can't fathom or rationalize it. Move past it. He deterred us from his section. Island daily. Well respected. Well connected. Look there. Tell me God gon' let us into heaven with you. Focus, you won't live. The net and what you post on it don't mean to a real. All it takes for you don't get your way and now you feel different. All it takes for you that paper, now you feel different. All it takes, don't talk you for a day and now you feel different. All it takes for you to catch a case and now you feel different. I swear I don't feel. Make me feel different. I swear I don't feel. Never feel different.
With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
The kicker, Graham Gano, set to put his foot into this one. And off we go from Soldier Field. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20.
At their own 18-yard line.
Smith going to go to the air, first play. Dancing to his left. That's complete to DK Metcalf. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. A well-executed 22-yard gain. Now Geno. Inside the 30. Big play here as they strike for 31.
All right, Charles, let me put you in the head of one of those defenders out there. You have a big play like that go against you so early. What does that shake your confidence?
It shouldn't, but it often does because your thought process all during the week is how you're going to get after that offense and make your plays. And when they make one against you, it makes you a little bit hesitant.
Time to regroup.
Well, that's one way you take away a first down as a defender. Make sure you have a little bit of physical play when the ball gets to the receiver. Find a way to jostle it free. They caught him off guard, forced the incompletion.
On the move to his left. He's got a man. It's his tight end. That's complete. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11. Backed up here, tough spot, needing 11 yards to pick up the first. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
And that might have been a situation where even though you don't hit on the deep throw, you at least put in the defenders' minds early in the game that we're going to press the ball deep against your secondary. And that can have a ripple effect on how they function throughout.
And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. Here we go on fourth. Smith. Oh, that is incomplete. The Ravens go for it, but come up empty. And this defense holds on the Knights' opening drive. Well, trying to be bold on the opening drive of the game, but that effort, it proves futile.
How many times have we talked with coaches where they've talked about taking the emotion out of their decision-making? I think that opening drive, if he didn't have it in his head to go for it before, I think that keyed into it. They were doing so well, and he decided to really establish something there. They didn't get it. Now they got to make sure that they don't lose their focus.
First and 10 at the 46-yard line.
They'll run it here. This is Deontay Foreman. And they'll wind up getting this to the 37. Gain of 9. The
the success there, Charles, coming on the outside of the field, the ground game. Curious to see if that continues as we progress.
Yeah, we often talk about a variety in play calling and usually between run and pass. But in this case, was
looking there for picks, but intercepted. Picked off by Anthony Walker. And he will bring this across midfield to the 49-yard line.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
That was nice work there defensively to force the incompletion. Now, even though this drive started in plus territory, they're still not in field goal range yet. So they can work towards another couple of stops and not allowing that turnover to hurt.
Smith's throw caught here by Metcalf. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Now it's Smith. Escaping the pressure right. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Different pass rushes are designed for different things. Sometimes you want to keep the quarterback in the pocket. Sometimes you want him to flush. I don't know exactly how this one was designed, but they made sure they moved him to his right. He got out of the pocket. Unfortunately for him, he was hit as he tried to throw the ball, and that resulted in an incompletion.
Catch is made by Metcalf. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. Back to throw, Smith. His pass caught at the 4. And in for the Ravens touchdown. Harold Carmichael from 8 yards out. And the Ravens take the early turnover and convert it into an opening touchdown. And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. Boy, so they don't get the conversion, but they're going to go right into the onside kick formation. Now the Bears electing to call a timeout defensively. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line. The Bears in good field position to start out first and 10 at the 41-yard line. Here's Fields. That pass complete to Moore. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. So in Raven territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 34. Fields. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Second and 10, Fields again. That's going to be caught by Pitts. And the Bears have tied the ball game with a chance to take the lead. Graham Gano on for the extra point. It's up and good, so they go the conservative route instead, and it gets them a 7-6 lead here in the opening quarter. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. Fair catch going to be taken, and this will be moved out to the 25. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. Second down, they go again with Henry. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. Give him four on the carry, and it'll make this a third and about two. In motion goes the tight end.
Hey, on tackle, on tackle.
They'll try and pick it up in McCaffrey. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. After one, a one-point game, 7-6. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Geno down a throw. Complete. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. So into Bear territory now. This is first and 10 at the 38. Here's Smith. And his throw is incomplete.
I like the calmness of how he played the ball here. No panic in his eyes as that throw arrived. Tracked it from the moment it left the quarterback's hand, and that's just where he needed to be to knock it away.
From the gun, here's Smith. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. And the Bears are going to have it here as they'll start at their own 24-yard line. Fields and the Bears now with a first and 10 at their own 24. They'll try and start this drive in the air. That's caught left side, the tight end Pitts. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Now a first down throw, Fields. That'll be caught by Foreman. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Fields now to throw. He's got the connection to Moore. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. So three plays, already first and goal, and they are wasting little time. Fields throwing again. Buying time to his left. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
Brandon, once that one broke down, there were only so many options left for him to take. Fortunately, only first down, so he smartly got the yardage he could get and didn't worry about trying to turn into a bigger play and end up taking a bigger loss. Here, they hope they can regroup and get something different going here on second down.
That'll be caught by Hester. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11.
3-yard loss on the play. It's third and goal.
Now Fields on third and goal. Got his man, and it's caught for a Chicago touchdown. Devin Hester, an 11-yard touchdown. And the Bears are able to widen their advantage.
They went five wide in that offensive set, and racing, going three wide, is a big deal. To go five, how about the way that they finish things off?
Did you just fit a race car reference into the game?
Zoom, zoom. How about the way that you play? When you go five wide, that means you're going fast now.
Zoom, zoom, indeed.
Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. But no run back here. Fair catch, and this will come out to the 25. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
Not an ideal way to end their previous drive. They threw the interception, Charles, after they had built up some momentum. They were moving the football. But something to at least build on for this offense as they run back out here.
Yeah, you're right about that. Up until that last play, everything was working pretty well for this offense. Gaining chunks of yardage, getting first downs, really making a push for the end zone, and looked like they had a nice rhythm going. Now you got to have a short memory here. Don't focus on the interception. Focus on what came before it and get back to it.
On first and 10, Smith. Pressure, and he's taken down. A Bear sack. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football.
Come on,
Yeah, they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. Smith. Finding Metcalf on the comeback route. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. Third and two, Smith. His early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. Picked off by Antonio Cromartie. And they will score. A pick six for the Bears touchdown. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
Run it like relay, bro. You ain't going like this. In my car, see straight, big fur jacket from